So here are actual real-life pictures of the ICSI setup, and I'll show you a video in just a minute so you'll understand it and not be afraid of it. But we have a micromanipulation apparatus that we set up that allows us to work with sperm that are only about 4 microns wide. And this is they are totally invisible to the naked eye, completely. And we pick them up with little micro pipettes that are pulled on a computer so that they're also the tip is completely invisible. And then under 400 power magnification, we're able to actually pick up the sperm in the micro pipette and then inject it into the egg. And then you can see the next day these two what we call pronuclei, the sperm pronucleus and the female egg pronucleus, indicate this egg has been normally fertilized. Now, it doesn't matter how bad the sperm are. This could be a man who's declared completely sterile. Or he may even have no sperm whatsoever in his ejaculate, and we might have to go to the testicle to directly retrieve the occasional few sperm that he's making because nothing is coming out in the ejaculate. And again, this procedure was invented at St. Luke's, so we have the most experience with it. And we can get fertilization rates no different than if the man were completely fertile using this really terrible-looking sperm. And we're able to pick out the few of those terrible-looking sperm that are normal. So again, to review, this is a picture of the actual ICSI procedure, injecting the sperm into the egg. And then this is the egg that's been fertilized at day one. And at day two, there's a 4-cell embryo. And at day three, it's an 8-cell embryo. So on day three, when we can really judge which embryos are likely to be viable and which are not, we transfer this embryo back to the woman in a procedure that's really completely painless. So up until now, the actual concept of preparing for IVF is very intimidating. When it comes right down to it, the actual embryo transfer is not intimidating at all, other than it's as simple as a routine yearly pap smear. Though I've said that the embryo transfer is a relatively simple, non-intimidating, I mean, what you think would be the dramatic, terrifying moment of IVF when we actually put the embryo back in the patient, you would think that would be difficult for you, but you'll find that easy. But let me just qualify that by explaining how tricky the embryo transfer is for the physicians and how important it is. Because we have people coming from all over the world who had beautiful embryos created in the lab and didn't get pregnant. And that failure to get pregnant, well, it's either caused by a genetic problem in the embryo, which we can diagnose with techniques we developed here, but that's not the common problem. The common problem is the method in which the embryo transfer is done. The transfer must be absolutely painless and non-irritating. And this requires that the couple have complete comfort level with the program because it requires a sense of emotional serenity. And I'll explain to you how we do that. First place, you're probably all familiar with this contraceptive called an IUD. When women have this intrauterine device put into their uterus because they've had all the children they want for a while, it prevents them from getting pregnant. At least it lowers the pregnancy rate to 0.5%. The IUD works by causing irritation in the uterus that is so minor the woman doesn't feel it, but this minor irritation prevents embryos from implanting. So she may have fertilization resulting from intercourse, and she may have developed a normal embryo, but when that embryo comes to the uterus from the fallopian tubes, it doesn't implant because of that subclinical minor little bit of irritation that's caused by the presence of the IUD. So with that knowledge, we realize that if we were to put the embryo back into your uterus in a way that is in the slightest bit irritating, and maybe you wouldn't even notice it, that will lower the pregnancy rate. And if it were to be put back in a way that is irritating or uncomfortable, or there's a little blood on the tip of the catheter, or in some way the doctors are having a difficult time getting it in, then this irritation can cause you to have a lower pregnancy rate. So two things we're going to ask you to do. Number one, don't fail to call us during the whole preliminary period for the 2 months prior to your IVF to ask any questions, because that's the best way you can reach a state of emotional calm. People don't often realize it, but this opening to your uterus, which is the cervix, is a very thick, powerful muscle that acts like a sphincter. And when you're uptight or anxious, that sphincter contracts and it closes down. Now notice the catheter. We have to put in a flimsy little catheter that is softer than a wet noodle, because only by using a wet noodle of a catheter can we be sure that we're not causing any irritation in the uterus. If you put in a stiff catheter, you'll have a little bit of irritation and that lowers the pregnancy rate. This wet noodle of a catheter will not go in unless your cervix is relaxed. Now, usually in IVF centers that refer to difficult transfers, they worry about blockage of the cervix or a bad angle or all these problems, and that really isn't the problem. Difficult transfers result in lower pregnancy rates, and they're caused by the sphincter being tight, and the physicians will try to get this catheter in. The only way they can is to load the embryo in a stiffer catheter. So we won't do that. Instead, what we'll do is make sure your sphincter relaxes so there's no pain and so that this soft little wet noodle can go in easily. So here's what we do. If we find that your sphincter is tight, we will ask you to do what we call muscle relaxation exercises. It kind of comes from ancient yoga, actually. If you can just sit there and just relax all your muscles, going from your neck and your shoulders and your chest all the way down to your ankles and your toes, just let everything relax. You can be as nervous as you want. You can be as anxious as possible about whether this is going to work or not, and it won't matter, because if you relax those muscles, then your cervical sphincter will relax and that soft catheter will pass in easily and we never have a difficult transfer. Now, okay, 1 or 2% of the time, there is so much anxiety associated with this that the woman can't even do this muscle relaxation. Her husband's in the room, he's holding her hand, she has emotional support, but she still just can't do it. There's just too much at stake for her to even relax her muscles. So in that case, we have anesthesia come in. This is not like a office procedure or an outpatient office procedure. We have true anesthesia available in the hospital, high quality, totally safe, and they can give you an anesthetic. Not just a mild tranquilizer doesn't work. It will not relax the cervical sphincter. But if anesthesia comes in and properly and safely puts you to sleep for 2 minutes, the catheter just slips right in, and then we wake you up right away. So we have the capability, because we're hospital-based, of giving you whatever you need to make sure that you don't have one of these office-based, quote, difficult transfers. We'll make sure it's a good transfer. And as I say, we're set for this, but you can make it even easier if you make sure to research everything, ask questions, and get as knowledgeable as you can so that you can reduce your level of anxiety about everything that's about to happen.